Welcome to this Volvo moment. Today we will talk to you about how we will recharge our business, how we will recharge our cars with customer care and sustainability. Key to sustainability is electrification. Together with investments in charging infrastructure, that is the right way to go. And that's the course we have chosen at Volvo. And we are well underway. Already last year, one car out of three we sold in Europe were a recharge model, that is a chargeable plug-in hybrid. By 2025, we plan to build half of our cars pure electric. And by 2030, then all our cars will be pure electric vehicles. The future customer offer cannot just consist of an electric car. We also need to listen to our consumers, and they expect transparency and a seamless experience getting and having a car. That's why all pure electric cars from Volvo will be available only online at preset prices. You can subscribe or buy. They will come with a special customer care package. They will all be equipped with specially developed recharge tires for all year safety and convenience. And they will be offered in special pre-selected configuration for fast delivery. This is how we will bring our consumer offering to the market in the future. And it also manifests our purpose as a company, and that is to provide people with the freedom to move in a personal, sustainable and safe way.
Do you drive around in today's heavy traffic without a seatbelt, in a car that offers poor protection? Then, if an accident happens, you will probably be badly hurt, even if your speed is only, say, 15 miles an hour. But why talk about injury? Why not avoid accidents instead?
Hey, I'm Björn, and I'm here at Volvo to find out what's the ultimate safety test. Look at this. Volvo cared about safety long before others. But how do they do it today? Come. Lipstick is not for looks. This is how they identify the airbag contact. These are the side and frontal crash tests. They're brutal. Yep, seems fine. Impressive, right? But is it the ultimate safety test? Me and Erika are heading up north to find out. Let's go. This is the big one, the 100-foot drop. So, is this the ultimate safety test? Well, it depends whether you...
Ultimate safety test, indeed. Climate change really is the biggest test we face as humanity. We recognize that we have been part of creating this problem, right? And as such, we really have to be part of building solutions, solutions that take us to zero emission mobility.
And that's why we made sustainability such a central part of our strategy for the future. Because we care about people, their safety and their well-being.
This is why we have an aggressive time plan in setting 2040 as the date where we will be fully climate neutral. And the supply chain is an imperative part here because with electrification, we add more CO2 with producing batteries into the supply chain as well as using more critical raw materials. So our partners are vital for us to achieve CO2 reductions.
We need to team up and speed up the transition for sustainable mobility.
I fully agree, and this collaboration piece is also key in the supply chain. Let's take the battery as an example, where we're dealing with a lot of critical raw materials that we need to secure is responsibly sourced. So we've partnered up with our suppliers of batteries and implemented blockchain technology for cobalt to secure that we know where the material is coming from all the way down to the mine. And we couple that with audits and on-the-ground monitoring to ensure we have responsible sourcing in place.
We need to be transparent about the challenges that we are facing, but also transparent about what we're doing about it, because we have a great challenge there. And I think that our customers, they want us to act, of course, but also understand what the challenges are.
Absolutely agree. And fundamentally, I think customers really want to choose a brand that cares about doing the right thing so they can drive electric Volvos with peace of mind.
Is changing, customer expectations are changing, mobility needs are changing. The way we use cars, the way we buy cars, the way we lease cars, the way we use the car to move from A to B, everything is changing. But what at the end prevails is convenience. We adapt and we embrace the change. But this does not happen overnight, but it will probably happen faster than what we are used to in the automotive industry. There are two trends where Volvo will play a role in the forefront. The first trend is electric cars, and the second one is that we will offer these cars online only. Electric is where the growth is for the premium part of the market, and by 2025, 50% of Volvo's volume will be fully electric. By 2030, we will be 100% electric. We stated earlier that convenience prevails, and that's where online enters the automotive world. I mean a real online experience and not a digitalized wholesale process. Simple, intuitive, with transparent pricing, easy to order, attractive cars. Built according to the personal taste or a pre-configured car with a quick delivery. This online experience will be working seamlessly in parallel with our retailer partners all over the world. Flawless online-offline experience. The customer selects the place to order online at volvocars.com. From their sofa, at the dealership, at a pop-up store, or at a Volvo store. So the entire experience of having a Volvo will become easier and more convenient, as convenience is key. A few years ago, we launched the Care by Volvo subscription service, an online-only offer with total flexibility. Now we will expand the meaning of Care by Volvo and create a convenient experience with the customer at the center. The XC40 Recharge and all future pure electric cars will be available with an extensive care package. And the care package, which includes insurance, maintenance, warranty, and where possible, home charging stations. With the XC40 Recharge, we take the first steps towards how Volvo will deliver growth, electrification, and a seamless online-offline customer experience together with our retail partners. When we achieve this, the sky is the limit for this company.
We talked a lot about electrification so far, but for that we need new electric cars. So let's have a look at the next one.
I am here to talk to you about something everyone's been eagerly waiting for. It's a completely new take on a Volvo. The first Volvo to be exclusively sold online. And Volvo's first ever electric-only car. The first of many that will be introduced in the coming years as we transform our entire portfolio into electric vehicles and take the lead in fully electric mobility. The C40 is much more than just an electric car. First off, it's got a fantastic looking design. While keeping the high seating position Volvo users want, the C40 actually features a lower profile than its XC40 sibling, as well as a much sleeker roofline. It also introduces an all new face and is the first Volvo with state-of-the-art pixel technology headlights. As for its propulsion, the C40 comes with twin motors front and rear and a 78 kilowatt hour battery that you can fast charge to 80% in about 40 minutes. It also boasts an anticipated range of around 420 kilometers, which is a great starting point that will improve over time as we continually update its software over the air. The day a brand new car leaves the factory, is no longer necessarily its finest. The C40 also comes with the best infotainment system on the market today, which is based on Google's Android operating system, enabling, where available, Google Maps for navigation, Google Assistant and Google Play Store for all the apps you need. You can use all those apps as much as you want, since the C40 also comes with unlimited data. The C40 is more than just cutting-edge technology. We're also taking a stance for animal welfare. It and all future pure electric Volvos will be 100% leather-free. So to wrap up, the C40 is a car that shows where we're going. All electric, only sold online, with exclusive Care by Volvo. Leather-free, continuously updated, and delivered quickly. But it will not be revealed here. It will be revealed where it belongs, in the streets of Tokyo, Milan, and New York. This is the future of Volvo.
for joining us here today, and welcome to the future of Volvo Cars.
So today we've revealed the all-new electric C40. Can you tell us a bit about it, please?
The C40, it's an amazing new pure electric only vehicle with our also amazing state-of-the-art, best on the market new navigation system that we saw in the XC40 based on the Google Android operating system. It also has state-of-the-art new pixel headlights, which are completely new. But I think the best feature of the vehicle, to be completely honest, is the amazing new design, which really tells you that you're driving a modern car that is pure electric.
And you mentioned the Android operating system. Why have you chosen that system?
Well, we have chosen that system basically because that gives the users the best experience. Both when it comes to the voice control, there is actually an assistant who understands what you say and what you intend to do or want the car to do for you. And it also has the absolutely best navigation system on the market, which is of course then powered by Google Maps. So you can find your way even if you know your destination or actually don't know exactly the name or the address. You can always search on restaurants or nearby locations in a way that are better than in any other navigation system, I would dare say. And then of course, on top of that, it gives you the access to the whole ecosystems of apps that will be made available on the Android platform, being the largest ecosystem for the future of car operating systems.
And this is a car that will improve over time with over-the-air updates. What sort of things are you planning to improve?
Well, the real exciting things with over-the-air updates in this particular car and all future car based on the same system within the Volvo family is that we can upgrade all parts of the software in this vehicle, not just the navigation or the infotainment system, which is quite common in the industry, but we can also update battery controls, we can update active safety functions, or we can update features that manages and monitors the e-machines. Every piece of software in the vehicle, basically, we can upgrade. That means we can work with efficiency improvements, range improvements, charging speed improvements, improvements in pilot assist, etc., with over-the-air updates in this vehicle and future Volvo models.
And another unique feature of the C40 is that it will be leather-free, as all future all-electric Volvos will be. Again, why have you made that decision?
Well, for us, this is about protecting not only the humans, but also the planet, and also in the extension of that, protecting the animals on the planet. So we have taken a stance for animal welfare and say, let's make this car and future pure electric vehicles leather-free.
So as we wrap up with C40, exciting day today as we reveal it to the public. What's your favorite feature? What are you most excited about?
Well, I have to say again, it's the look of the car. It's a really, really beautiful car and it stands out. When I drive that car, I will feel really proud. I'm driving sustainable, I'm driving safe, I'm driving personal, and I'm driving in the best looks on the street.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So today we've announced that we're going to be selling our pure electric cars online only. Do you really think customers are ready for online sales?
I think I'd rather ask the question, is the automotive industry ready for online sales? Because we strongly believe that the customers are ready for it. We see it in the rest of society. I think COVID-19 has accelerated that entire process. But we also have now the experience with Care by Volvo since 1.5, 2 years, where you can subscribe to a flex program online only. And there we see a very, very high interest of customers to order online, either from their sofa or from their phone, or going to the dealership and order the car together with the retailer online.
So you say our customers are ready, but the industry might not be. What does this mean for our retailers? Are they part of this journey? Are they ready for it?
Our retailers are a total integrated part of this journey. What we try to do is, first of all, we want to fulfill a demand coming from the customers. They want to have convenience, hassle-free experience, order a car online. But not everybody can do it, want to do it, or simply want to visit a dealership because they want to see the car, touch the car, and talk to the professional staff. So we create an online, offline consumer experience, consumer journey. and that a retailer is a total integrated part of.
So the customer can choose whether they go into a retailer and order online or whether they order online from their own home. But there's more to what's being announced today than purely the mechanism of buying cars online. We talked about transparent pricing, for example. What else is there to this move online?
No, I think this transparent prices is a very, very important element. Because what we also increasingly learn is that people do not want to go through this negotiation process or visit multiple dealerships because they want to have the feeling that the price they have is the best price they can get. And now we as a manufacturer put a price on, which is obviously very competitive, but this is the price you have to pay for this car. And that brings actually a rather significant peace of mind, but also the entire buying process is very much simplified. What we are trying to do is buy or order a car in the same way as you order your sofa or your TV online. Very convenient, very simple, but also a simplified offer from a product perspective, because of course you can put your car together online, but that's a pretty complex process given the number of options we have available. So we have elected a number of cars where we think that will be the most popular cars. They are available for instant delivery, and that makes it even more convenient.
So you get that instant delivery and you get the simplified product offer, but there's more to that as well. The care package has been announced today. What does that include?
That's yet another aspect of our hassle-free experience. But we want, there is, and especially on the recharge car, but we will expand this later to other car lines. But, you know, it's a full electric car. There are still, many people still need to experience what it means. It's new territory. I mean, what about the quality? What about the range? Is this a car for me? How does it work? What's the residual value after a period? So that's why we said we're offering, first of all, we're offering subscription possibilities, but you can also buy the car cash. But on top of that, we said, okay, let's take away all the concerns, at least for the first 3 years. So what we include, 3 years of warranty, 3 years of service. So actually, you don't have to bother about anything. Insurance is included in numerous countries, and we are rolling that out. And another aspect is that we have charging boxes, which is normally could be an interesting experience to order one. You can now click online at the Volvo shop and we connect you to a supplier, and it's all integrated in the process.
The pure electric cars, online only, with the care package, fast delivery, clearly a very convenient way for customers to buy their pure electric Volvo. But we've also announced today that by 2030, we will only be selling pure electric cars. Do you really think customers are ready for pure electric? Is that the demand that we see, or is there a potential commercial risk there?
It's always difficult to predict what's happening in 10 years from now. But if I look back for 1.5 years and see the journey Volvo went through with plug-in hybrids, no, it's not a full electric car. It's still combined with a combustion engine. But we have increased from almost zero in 2 to 3 years. Now in Europe, we are on 30%, and most likely in the entire world, we will end up around 30%. So that encourages very much that that electrical cars will enter society. Will it happen at the same speed at every continent? Of course not. But you know, we have to start somewhere. We strongly believe that this is very close to what Volvo stands for.
So a significant way, a change in the way we're really going about our business as Volvo Cars.
Yeah, you said it already. We go fully electrified and we go online. And by that, we are fulfilling the needs of the customers and trying to create a hassle-free consumer experience.
Great. Thank you very much, Lex. So we've announced today that Volvo Cars will be fully electric by 2030. Why have we made that decision?
It is in line really with our sustainability commitment. That's one answer. Customers are asking more and more for electric cars, and the transition we believe will be faster than maybe we thought a year ago. That's one answer. The other is really consumer demand. And they are not just asking for electric cars, they are also asking for a hassle-free way of getting and having a car. So that's something we also combine with this. You could say we expand now the scope, not just to electrification, it's a sustainable offering to consumers with a much better transparency and a better customer care.
So you've talked in the past about the growth opportunities for Volvo cars. Do you see electrification as a key driver in that field, or is narrowing down to pure electrification potentially limiting your market?
No, I believe the electric segment will be the new premium segment. So that will be the growing segment. And I think we are wise if we concentrate on a growing profitable premium segment, and that's where we are now entering into.
And these electric cars now going to be sold online only. Are consumers really ready for online sales? Is that something that we think our retailers, our partners are ready for as well?
I believe they will be. I mean, we have had a lot of dialogue with our retailers. I think it's important to say we're not going to sell cars totally isolated on the web. I don't think consumers are ready for that, picking up in a harbor. I mean, that's not going to happen. So, but we need a transparent offering on online. More and more people want to browse online to see what's the price of this model. And they expect also that to be the price. I think nobody's really interested in going around and negotiating with various dealers. So transparent set pricing. That's one really the key element on the online sales. But the physical delivery will, of course, still happen at the retailers. They have to deliver the car, explain the car and service it exactly as today.
So these pure electric cars, transparent pricing online, and they come with this care package. Can you tell us a bit about what that care package means?
That's also a very important element, and I believe we are trying to bundle now everything. It's not just putting an electric motor in our cars. That will not be enough to make us successful. Customer care, absolutely important, the transparency, but then the care package. I like that as well. So a really hassle-free way of having a car. Maintenance included, repair, if needed, is of course included. And also insurance, a full insurance, which should be as flat rate as possible according to the regulations. In most countries will be absolutely flat. That means flat independent of who is driving the car, age, and also the geography, where you drive the car. And the first 3 years are included in the price if you buy a car. If you subscribe, then it's of course included as long as you subscribe.
And you've talked about consumer demand for electrification and how that drives the growth. Do you think this combination of online sales, the care package, what's being offered today in terms of the new commercial approach will support that consumer demand?
Absolutely. And also I think there is a very natural connection. People who are interested in sustainability, I mean, it starts really with our brand, expanding the brand promise into sustainability and environmental friendly cars, zero CO2 emissions. That's one thing. But people who are attracted to those values are most likely also to be attracted by transparency, or online offering, hassle-free care package, but also quick delivery, which is something we offer as well, because we will have pre-specified variants, say 4 or 5 for each car model, and those will be available for a very rapid delivery. But if you want something really customized, we can deliver that as well. But then, of course, the delivery time will be a bit longer. So that's one element. And I think also one very important one are the tires. A small thing, but I mean, I've heard nobody that loves changing tires 2 times a year. And also maybe forgetting it and driving with a really unsafe tire. So all our BEV cars will also come now with specially developed recharge tires for all-year safety and in a very convenient way. That's also an important element of our offering.
And you mentioned sustainability just then, and it's a position within our company purpose. And obviously electrification is a key part there, but we're looking to focus a lot more on sustainability and really elevate sustainability. So we're known for that area in the same way that we are safety. Can you tell us a little bit more about what sustainability really means for Volvo Cars?
It's really two areas. First is the usage of the car, and there, of course, the electrification and zero tailpipe emission is very important. But it's also about the carbon footprint a car will leave behind during its life. So, I mean, from also the production and logistic building and delivering a car, that's really important as well. And there we also have a commitment till 2025 to reduce that with 25%. And that combined with the usage, which will be reduced by 50%, bring us to total reduction of the carbon footprint of 40%. And that's, of course, a very concrete step, 2025, towards, of course, our vision to be climate neutral.
So short-term actions, long-term goals as well. And one of those, before we wrap up today, the new C40 has been unveiled this afternoon. Tell us a bit about the C40. What are you most excited about?
It's a very attractive car. First of all, we see there is growth now in smaller cars, premium cars, with a high seating position, easier to get in and out, excellent visibility as for the XC40, but not all consumers want maybe that big luggage compartment as a traditional SUV. So this has another roof line, much more sporty roof line, and also all new front. So it looks, I think, a very dynamic car and offers alternative for people looking for a car in this size. So it broadens our offer and makes us grow into the electric segment.
Great. Thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you.